everyone give a shout out to the parents of the bride and groom for helping this wedding possible.
All right, up first we have
Becca, escorted by Justin.
All right, now we've got Jesse, escorted by Rose. And then make some noise for the maid of honor, Katie, escorted by the best man, Zane! Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Burmeister!
Everyone's attention up here towards the head table. We are going to begin some toasts. Up first, we are going to hear from the groomsman, Justin. So give it up for Justin, everybody.
All right, all right. Mic check, mic check. Say boom, boom, let me hear you say well. All right, all right. My name's Justin. My name's Justin. I'm one of Jake's best friends, and we live together up at Central. Fire up. I love it. I love it. Hey, and I speak for the room when I say you look absolutely breathtaking this evening. Jake, you got to be careful, man. Jake, you got to be careful. First she stole your heart, now she's stealing your last name. Now it's going to be the Beamer next. You got to watch out. But I've known Jake for a long time. Unfortunately, Zane wasn't able to stay today. Our thoughts and prayers go out to him and his family. So you would think that I would be best man by default, but that wasn't the case. About 15 minutes ago, I had an intense rock, paper, scissors battle with with Jocelyn, the bartender over there. But hey, the best man comes out on top. But I've been with Jake and Hannah ever since they started dating. I got to see their love grow and blossom to what it is now. And it's absolutely amazing to see how beautiful you guys are. Sorry, I told myself I wouldn't get choked up, but it's an emotional day. I mean, even the cake is in tears. But I'm so happy that I can be here to share in this milestone. And I know that you guys are going to be great parents whenever that day comes. And I'm excited to be there every step of the way. So guys, please raise your glass to the new Mr. and Mrs. Burmeister. Matt, here you go, buddy.
Thanks, buddy. Next, we're going to hear a speech from the maid of honor, Katie. So give it up for Katie, everybody.
Tonight. I don't know about you guys, but I've been waiting for this day for a very long time. For those of you who don't know me, I've had the pleasure of being friends with Hannah and Jake for the last 7 years. The magic of Central Michigan University, fire up tips, brought Hannah and I together. We were in the same business program. We had 90% of our classes together. We were both bleach blonde. We were slightly obsessed with our cats. And we love to drink on Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. I promise we got an education too. Just a couple weeks after Hannah and I started our friendship, the magic of CMU struck again, and Hannah and Jake met at Pint Night for the first time. And as well you heard in Jake's vows, the rest is history. They both love to drink on Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. And shortly after they met, Jake grew to become slightly obsessed with Hannah's cat Bella, even though he will never admit it. And he also became a bleach blonde. Raise your hand if you remember when Hannah was vegan and Jake was bleach blonde. Yeah. The real ones remember, and may we never forget. We've come a long way since those days. I think the greatest thing about my friendship with Hannah and Jake is that I've been there since the beginning. I remember their first date. Who cut the onions? I remember when Jake asked Hannah to be his girlfriend. I remember the phone call before Jake said, "I love you" first. And the phone call after. And I remember leaving CMU and walking at graduation together and knowing that we would be friends forever. I can't fail to mention all the other milestones that guided you both to becoming husband and wife today. Like when you moved to Indiana together and didn't know a single soul, and look at all the friends you created there. Like when you adopted the chunkiest cat I've ever met, bought your first home and set down roots in Michigan, and when you officially started the Edgeworth Zoo when you rescued Stevie. You've built a really incredible life together. When I sat down to write this speech and what to say tonight, one word kept coming to mind: reliable. Hannah and Jake are the most reliable couple I've ever met. I can always rely on them to be up for an adventure, even if that adventure is walking 3.5 miles in the middle of the night from the Blackstone to Copper Beach Apartments. Yeah, if you know Mount Pleasant, you know. I can always rely on Jake to tell me what I need to hear and not what I want to hear. Like that one time he told me my ex-boyfriend treated me like crap, and I finally gained the courage to dump him a few weeks later. Thanks again for that one, bud. You helped me see my worth, and I'll never be able to thank you for that. I can always count on Hannah to talk on the phone with me for over an hour about the same things over and over again, or be down for a craft night and watch the Lizzie McGuire movie. And most importantly, I can always rely on them to be great friends. You guys always show up for the people that you love. I wouldn't be the person I am today without you guys. I love you so much, and I couldn't be happier to add today as another core memory spent with the both of you. I can't wait to see what else you accomplish and build together over the next 7 years of our friendship. So let's all raise our glasses and cheers to the new Mr. and Mrs. Burmeister. Oh my goodness. May you rely on each other as husband and wife and partners in crime. Cheers, I love you both so much.
Up next, we are going to hear from the father of the groom, Dan. So everybody give it up for Dan, everybody.
Hey, everyone. Can you guys hear me? All right, I'm glad to be here. It's been a journey to get here. I'm really happy. Louder, a little louder now. Okay, it's been a journey. I'm glad to have everybody here. It's very exciting. So I'll start with getting a lot of advice here on the microphone. How's this right now? Go with my left hand. Good? All right. So it's been a journey. So Jake was always kind of an easy baby when he was little. He'd crawl along on the floor and then just kind of fall asleep in the family room. That was great for a while. Then as he got a little older, if there was a puddle, he would sprint toward it, fall in it, roll in it. Just was active, a little hyper for us. We had little struggles there, but he continued to grow. You know, he became a strong negotiator, smart kid. He went on to Central, and we said, we're really happy. I think things are going well, but I know he's running through puddles somewhere. And then Tammy came home from a visit to CMU, and she said, Jake brought this girl over, and She's really pretty, she's sweet, but she laughs at everything that Jake says. So Hannah, we were a little worried about you because we're like, I don't know if that's the right judgment. But then Hannah came to our house and she was sweet, smart, and we really got to know her. She's got that strong sense of humor. But you know, what's really interesting is there's many times Jake and I will be out doing something and I come to and I realize this, Hannah had a plan, sent us out on a journey, and now we're doing her bidding. She does a great job of doing that. But most importantly, we're just so happy to have both of you guys together. And we know that you guys will run through the puddles together, under control, for the rest of your lives. And we love you and your family. It's great to have you as part of our family now. So let's raise a toast to Jake and Hannah. So.
And next, we are going to hear from the father of the bride, Dave. So give it up for Dave, everybody.
That's kind of a hard act to follow. Damn. So anywho, what I think of most tonight, and Hannah, I'm going to embarrass Hannah maybe a lot. I remember when she was like 14 or 15 years old. We'd be watching television, kind of watching the TV, she'd be next to me and I'd pause the TV and say, no man will ever be good enough for you. Then I go back to watching TV. And then a week later, we'd be watching TV and I'd pause the TV and go, no man will ever be good enough for you. Then we go back to watching TV. And I really believe that, right? As any dad would. Then one day, this Jake Burmeister character showed up. And I'm like, what is this Jake Burmeister thing? Like, what is this all about? Huh. So I kind of looked him over, and I'm like, he kind of looks okay. He smells okay, like for the most part, you know. Like, all right, you know, maybe. He had some good traits. He had a nice family, seemed like a good kid, seemed to work hard. He was really good at sarcasm. And I'm like, yes, that's pretty, goddamn, the kid's got sarcasm mastered. He liked cars, he liked firearms, he liked watches. I'm like, check, 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 that's pretty freaking good. I'm like, all right, I'm kind of down with this. Then I met his family. And I'm like, oh God, it's kind of like the last test, right? Oh my God, here comes mom and dad. We're gonna meet mom and dad. And I'm like, I'm gonna curse. They're fucking adorable. Oh my God, I love both of them. So Jake Burmeister, you totally freaking proved me wrong. A man is good enough for my daughter. God bless. Cheers to Mr. and Mrs. Burmeister.
Now at this time, have everyone's attention back to the head table for a few quick words.
I don't have a crazy speech like everyone else does. I just wanted to say a quick thank you for everyone, to everyone for coming. We really appreciate it and we hope you have a good time. Do whatever you need to do at the bar to get on the dance floor when they start playing music. No clean versions of the song will be played tonight, so get out there. Thank you again.
Now at this time, I'm going to go ahead and ask our bride and groom to come on out into the dance floor to share their first dance as man and wife.
Forever on the road, cones burn like memories of the mind.
Give him a big old round of applause, everybody.
Now at this time, I am going to go ahead and open up the dance floor. Don't be shy. Come on out.
If you catch me at the border, I got visas in my name. If you come around here, I'll make them all day. I get one down in a second if you wait. I fly like paper, get high like planes. If you catch me at the border, I got visas in my name. If you come around here, I'll make them all day. I get one down in a second if you wait. Sometimes I think sitting on trains. Every stop I get to, I'm clocking that game. Everyone's a winner, we're making our fame. Bonafide hustler, I think sitting on trains. Every stop I get to, I'm clocking that game. Everyone's a winner, we're making our fame. Bonafide hustler, making my name.
Every long, long stream led me to where